Hello friends, welcome back. I am Dr. Shankar here and you are watching My Exam Coaching. So what is your topic today? We have a new topic today, that is percentage, and that is part 1. So in part 1 of percentage, I have brought some very interesting questions for you, which have been frequently asked in the previous question papers. So we have selected some important questions from previously asked questions. Okay. So when we solve these type of questions, I'm sure you will have an idea of how to approach these type of questions. Okay. So some of the important shortcuts methods also we are using while solving the questions. So questions, important questions based on percentage and how to approach solving those questions. That is the main topic of today's class. Okay. So let us solve some of the important questions. Let us go to the class. So here is our first question. 50% of A equal to 25% of B. Then A is equal to X percentage of B. Find X. So four options are also given to you, students. So what is given? Let us write that first. So what is given? 50% of A is equal to 25% of B. That is the first information given to you. So for explanation, I am writing all these things and doing it. But as far as your competitive exams are concerned, you need not to write everything here. You can make it short and then find out the answer. It is very easy. For explanation part, let us do the first question like this. 50% of A is equal to 25% of the B. That is given. And then it is also given that A is equal to X percentage of B. That means A equal to X percentage of B. This is also another information given to you. So you have to find out what is the value of X. X we need to find out here. So here you can say 50% of A equal to 25% of B. Remove that percentage both the sides. Now 50 and 25 I can cut. Here 2 times, here 1 time. 25 2 times, 25 1 time. So what I got? I got 2A is equal to B. 2A is equal to B. This information we will use here. A is equal to X percentage of B. So what does it mean? A is equal to X percentage can be written as X by 100. X percentage can be written as X by 100. Into of B into B. So either you put in place of B, you put 2A, or from here I can make A is equal to half of B. If 2A is equal to B, then I can write A is equal to B by 2. So either you put in place of A, I can write B by 2, or in place of B, I can put 2A, anything. So we will write A is equal to X by 100 into in place of B, I am putting 2A. Now I can cancel A and A both the sides. Here 2 times A, here 1 time A. So what will get? 2X divided by 100 equal to 1, cross multiply. So what I will get? When I cross multiply, 100 is equal to 2X. So what will be X? X is equal to 50. So I got the answer, I got the value of X, X is equal to 50. Isn't it interesting? Yes, it is easy, very easy. So what we have done, once again we will see, as per the question given below, in your question paper, we have taken 50% of A is equal to 25% of B. So understand students, whenever we have percentage questions, of means multiplication. Simply you can replace this of by multiplication. Percentage if comes both sides, actually percentage means what? Percent. Percent. Send means 100. Percent. Out of 100, how much? That is percentage meaning. So here also 50% means 50 by 100. Here also 25% means 25 by 100. Both sides 100 are there. So we are canceling that 100. So what actually we are doing? We are removing that percentage. Here also we are cutting that percentage. That's it. Okay. So now here 50, here 25. I can cut it with 25 two times, here 25 one time. So I got what? 2 of A, that is 2 into A. 2A is equal to 1 of B, 1 into B, B. So I got B is equal to 2A, or you can say A is equal to B by 2. We will use this information to find the value of X. What is given? X is given how A is equal to X percentage of B. That is, A is equal to X by 100 into B. Of means into multiplication. Here in place of B, you got 2A. So in place of B, I can put what? 2A. Cut that A and A. Here A will go 2 times. Here A will go 1 time. So what I got? 2X. 2X divided by 100 will be equal to 1. Cross multiply. 100 is equal to 2X. So X is equal to 50. So I got the answer. So this is very simple question, and this type of questions are asked in your question paper. You can note it. Okay, so let us go to the next question. The next question is, if 20% of A plus B equal to 50% of A minus B, that is 20% of A plus B is equal to 50% of A minus B. The information given in the question I am writing. 20% of A plus B is equal to 50% of A minus B. What you have to find out? You have to find the ratio A is to B. You have to find the ratio A is to B. You have to find out. Okay, now let us go with this question. Here, as we have done in the previous question, students, you can cancel percentage both the sides. So I am canceling percentage both the sides, isn't it? Now 20 and 50, I can cancel this 0 and I can cancel this 0. So now I got a 2 into A plus B. This of will be multiplication. 2 into A plus B is equal to 5 into 5 of A minus B. 5 into A minus B. Of will become multiplication. So 2 of A plus B means 2 into A plus B. 5 of A minus B means 5 into A minus B. Just solve this. 2 into A, 2A. 2 into B, plus 2B. 5 into A, 5A. 5 into B, minus 5B. Now what we will do, we will just transpose these things. B and A to one side. So I am taking 2A here. I have minus 5B here. I am taking this minus 5B to this side. So here already we have 2B. This minus 5B, when I take this side, it will become plus 5B. Here already you have 5A. This 2A, I am taking that side, it becomes minus 2A. So 2B plus 5B, I got 7B. 5A minus 2A, I got 3A. So now I got this. 7B equal to 3A. We want A is to B. So A is to B means A by B. A by B, with A, what we have? 3. That 3 will come on the down. With this B, what we have? 7. That 7 will go to the top. So our answer will be 7 is to 3. That is your answer. 7B is equal to 3A. What we have to do? A by B. A by B. So we are finding out A by B. Cross multiplication, A by B, with A we have 3, so that 3 will go down, and with the B we have 7, 7 will be in the top. So A by B, that is A is to B, is equal to 7 is to 3. So that is the required answer. Can I remove it? Okay, if you are not completed it, please pause the video and complete it. Very interesting question and very easy questions. So let us go to the next question. What is our next question? Okay, if 90% of P equal to 30% of Q and Q equal to 2x percentage of P, find P. 90% of P equal to 30% of Q. What is given? 90% of P is equal to 30% of Q. 90% of P is equal to 30% of Q. And what else is given? Q is equal to 2x% of P. Q is equal to 2x% of P. This information is also given in the question. So you have to find out what is P. Now here we can cut that percentage both side, 0, 0 both side. So what I will get? 9P is equal to 3Q. Again I can cut it with 3. So this will become 3P is equal to Q. 3 I can cut one time, in 3 it is 3 times. 3P is equal to Q. So I got an information here. Now we will use it here. Q is equal to 2x% of P. But we know Q is equal to 3P. That means 3P is equal to 2x/100 into P. Cut P both the sides and cross multiply. So you got a 300 is equal to 2x. Therefore, x is equal to 300/2, which is equal to 150. That is your answer. Please note this. So you should have an idea how to approach this type of questions. Questions are not tough. Only thing, you need to practice 3-4 questions for understanding the concept. Once you understood the concept, then you have to select lot of questions and practice every day. Then you can increase your speed. That itself, that's only required for cracking any competitive exams. First, understand the concept. Means have a clear concept how to approach this type of question. 90% of P, we don't know P. 90% will be taken as 90/100, and the school method that we need not to do here, it's a competitive exam. So you have to go with the shortcut methods. So approach should be correct, then you will get the correct answer. And then to increase the speed, you have to select more and more questions and practice. 1 to 1.5 hours of practice every day is more than enough to crack this type of competitive exams. Okay, so you can note it and we'll go to the next question. So what is our next question? 20% of P is equal to 30% of Q. P is equal to x% of Q, find x. 20% of P equal to 30% of Q. So whatever is given, we will write that. 20% of P is equal to 30% of Q. Now see, friends, I will tell you, after solving 3-4 questions, you need not to write even this. 20% of P is equal to 30% of Q. Directly you can write it 2P is equal to 3Q. That will come by practice. That is what I am telling. Only for the purpose of explanation, I am writing all these things. Because I have to explain it, that is why I am writing. So when you practice it, more and more questions are practiced, then you need not to write even this line. Directly you can write it 2P is equal to 3Q from the question itself. So you can save a lot of time. Okay, that come only by practice. So at least every topic what we are learning in this videos, every topic have a concept clarity, then take more and more questions and practice. 1 to 1.5 hours of practice every day, more than enough. Okay, that will increase your speed. So what is given in the question? 20% of P is equal to 30% of Q. So from here itself I can write this 0 and this 0 cut, percentage and percentage cut, I have written 2P is equal to 3Q. Now what is the other information given in your question? The other information is P equal to x% of Q. So we'll take it here. P equal to x% of Q. So what is the meaning of that? P, see, 2P is equal to 3Q. 2P is equal to 3Q. From here I can write P is equal to 3Q divided by 2. So in place of P, I will take 3Q divided by 2 is equal to x/100 into Q. I have removed Q. So 3/2 equal to x/100, cross multiply, 3 into 100, 300, 2 into x, 2x, 300 equal to 2x, therefore x is equal to 300 divided by 2, 150. Very easy question. Okay, you can note it. So let us go to the next question. Okay, so what is our next question? So our next question is like this. If 60% of P minus Q is equal to 40% of P plus Q, that is 60% of P minus Q is equal to 40% of P plus Q. One information given in the question. And what is next given? Then you have to find out 2P minus 3Q by P plus Q. What we have to find out is 2P minus 3Q divided by P plus Q. This is what we have to find out, how much it is. So let us go with this. Percentage and percentage, both the side cancel. 0 and 0, both the side cancel. Here it will be left with 6. 6 into P minus Q is equal to 4 into P plus Q. I am elaborating it. 6 into P, 6P. Minus 6 into Q, 6Q. Equal to 4 into P, 4P. Plus 4 into Q, 4Q. So now what I am doing is, I am taking this Q and P transpose. Here you have 6P. I am taking this 4P here. So I will get 6P minus 4P. Here already I have 4Q. I am taking this minus 6Q that side. So it will become plus 6Q. 6P minus 4P, 2P. 4 plus 6, 10Q. So from here I can make P. What is P? P is equal to 10Q divided by 2, 5Q. So we have these two informations. Isn't it? Now we will use this information to find out this. Here 2P minus 3Q. 2P can be taken as 10Q. So here I will take 10Q minus 3Q divided by P plus Q. So in place of P, I can put 5Q. So P plus Q, that is 5Q plus Q. So what answer I got? 10Q minus 3Q, 7Q. 5 plus 1Q, 6Q. Q and Q cancel. So I got 7 by 6. That is the answer. Please note it. So these type of questions are very frequently asked, students. These type of questions are very frequently asked questions. You have to find out P minus Q, X minus Y, M minus N, K minus X, A minus B. Anything can be asked. Instead of 60% and 40%, there will be questions like a 30%. So what actually happens? The pattern will not change. Only the numbers will change. 60, 40. In place of 60% and 40%, the new question may come like 20% or 30%. Like that only the number will change, but the pattern remains same. So if you have a concept clarity, then clearing all these questions are not difficult. It is easy only. It comes only by practice. So the more you practice, you can increase your speed. That is what I want to tell you. Okay, next question. What is our next question? If 50% of Q is equal to 20% of P plus Q. 50% of Q is equal to 20% of P plus Q. That is given in the question. Now what is next? And find the value of 2P minus Q by 2P plus Q. What you have to find out is 2P minus Q divided by 2P plus Q. Okay. So same type of question, what we have already done, this type of questions already we have solved. So now I am sure, pause the video and try it yourself and find out the answer. Okay, I am giving you 1 minute time. Pause the video, try yourself and find out the answer and check with your option, correct options. Then let us solve it. Okay, so what we will do, what is the approach? Percentage, percentage, both the side cancel. 0, 0, both the side cancel. What is left out here? 5 and Q. So 5Q is equal to 2 into P plus Q. So now 5Q is equal to 2P plus 2Q. I am taking this 2Q this side. So this will become 5Q minus 2Q. This will become 3Q. Here already we have 5Q. I will take this plus 2Q this side, it will become minus. So 5Q minus 2Q, 3Q is equal to 2P. So we got 2P is equal to 3Q.
let it be like this. I am using this value there, 2p minus q, but I know 2p is equal to what? 2p is equal to 3q. So 2p in place of 2p, I can put what? I can put 3q. So I'll put 3q minus q divided by in place of 2p. In place of 2p, I can put 3q. So 3q plus q. So how much it will be? 3q minus q, 2q. 3q plus q, 4q. Q and q cancel. So finally, we got the answer 2 by 4. 2 by 4 again, you can cancel it and it will become 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is the correct answer. Okay. Next question. So the next question is, if 60% of P equal to 20% of Q, what is given? 60% of P is equal to 20% of Q. And what else is given? P equal to X percentage of Q. P equal to X percentage of Q. So you have to find out what is Q. So here again, percentage and percentage cancel. This type of question already we have done in our first example and second example. This type of question already we have completed. So still, for more practice, percentage, percentage cancel, 0 and 0 cancel. Here left with the 6. 6 of P means 6P. 2 of Q means 2q. Again, you can cut it 2 one time, here 2 three times. So you got 3p is equal to q. Keep this information there. Q is equal to 3p. That means p is equal to x percentage, x by 100 of, means multiplication, in place of q, I can put 3p. So I am putting 3p here. Cut this p, cut this p one time, one time. So what I will get? 1 is equal to 3x by 100. Cross multiplication, I will get 3x is equal to 100. If 3x is equal to 100, x is equal to 100 by 3, which is equal to 33.33. That is the correct answer. 33.33% you can say. Send it. Yes. Can I remove? Let us go to the next question. What is our next question? If P is 20% less than Q, then find the value of Q minus P by Q and P minus P by Q minus P. If P is 20% less than Q, it is given P and Q are given to you. Isn't it? P and Q are given to you and a condition is given. This is a different type of question, students. P and Q are given to you and a condition is given that P is 20% less than Q. So we don't know what is P, we don't know what is Q. So let us, this type of questions, we will take an assumption. What is assumption? P is 20% less than Q is given. So let us take Q is equal to 100 and P is equal to 80. So automatically P will be 20% less than Q. P is 20% less than Q. That is a condition given. So whenever you have condition like this, we have taken like this. Okay. Now what is the next part? What we need to find out? We need to find out Q minus P by Q. First part we have to find out Q minus P by Q. Q minus P by Q. That is the first part we have to find out. And second part what we have to find out is P by Q minus P. P by Q minus P. That is what we have to find out. Okay. So let us take this way. P and Q, a condition is given. P is 80% less than Q. Isn't it? Now let us take this first one. Q minus P. That is 100 minus 80 divided by Q. 100. Second part is P, that is 80, Q minus P, 100 minus 80. So 100 minus 80 will become 20 by 100. This will become 80 by 100 minus 80, 20. I can cut this 0 and this 0. 2 and 10, this will become 1 by 5. 0 and 0 cut. 2 and 4, this will become 4. So my answer is 1 by 5, comma 4. This is the correct answer.
So questions are not tough. The approach should be correct. And if your concept is very clear, then you can easily solve this type of questions. So students, these are the very important questions selected from your previous question papers. Okay, so give importance to these questions and have a clear concept clarity on this type of questions. Okay, this type of questions are only asked in your basic questions based on percentage. And in part 2 of percentage, we will be solving some more important questions based on salary, numbers, what percentage of a number is what, and all this different type of questions will be solving in part 2. And part 2 is more important than part 1. But I request you, before watching part 2, watch part 1 so that you will get a clear concept on the topic percentage. Okay. So prepare well, and students, I request you, if you are not subscribed for our beautiful channel My Exam Coaching, please subscribe now so that whenever I upload new topics and new videos, it will definitely reach you. Okay, take care. Bye bye.